apocalyptic, doesn't it?
Wow.
Yep. Hey, everybody, welcome back to the Couch Couple Gaming Play as Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. You may be wondering why we are here at the Maw of Death Mountain instead of, you know, back in Zora's domain dealing with Muzu's bullshit. That's because I realized I had 7 spirit orbs. I wanted to get an 8th one before I go off to fight the Lynel, because we all know what a bitch, what an asshole that guy is. I would like to go in with a little extra hearts, with a little extra health, so here we go. Just gotta get one more shrine in, so.
Let's do it.
Let's do these. This is also the nearest shrine I could get to at the time, so. Metal makes a path. Okay, I see. We grab the metal ball over here. Fuck it. You know, I'm gonna... That's right. I need to do stasis first. Now we use this. Gotcha! This thing makes fucking lifting heavy objects no joke. Can we use this huge ass thing? Let's fucking power our way through! Look at that.
Wow, fruit.
Plowing through, brute force our way in. Was there a treasure chest? Of course, it's over there where the metal ball runs up. So I'm gonna go get that really quick. There we go. Yeah, I'm just gonna go get that really quick since I really derailed the balls. The balls of death. You can't see the chest from all the way over there, all the way down there, so... Gimme. A knight's broadsword. Damn it. What can I drop? What can I afford to drop? I'll drop the spiked moblin club. I was also gonna use it to break some boxes anyway. Skip along. Almost pulled an Indiana Jones there.
Almost.
All right, so yeah, that was a fairly straightforward shrine.
Well, that was simple.
Mm-hmm. And I like how the stone balls just magically disappear. But dude, how'd you get all this lava in here? Unless this was built, like, directly over a lava vein. Find yourself surrounded by an overwhelming number of enemies. Ice arrows to freeze them in their tracks. Yeah, ice arrows will freeze them for quite a while.
Yeah, they could.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so that's another shrine down. I'm thinking we'll get 2 heart containers. And I guess the next 4 will go to a stamina thing.
Okey-doke.
Like I said, I wanted to have more health ready for when I go to fight the Lynel.
Sounds good.
I know fighting the Lynel is not required, but I want to do it. Make up for all the times that fucker killed me when I was the first time I played this game. Training your horse. How to train your horse. Like the movie, How to Train Your Dragon. Alright, let's see. I don't care what you say! Muzu, please listen. Oh, God. Muzu, are you seriously gonna be a cantankerous old fart about this the whole time? It sure as hell seems like you are. So, let's talk to him. came all the way here, but it was in vain. I have no desire to speak with you. Yeah, go fuck yourself, buddy. Child, then, I did not know it myself at the time.
Da-da. No! It's not possible! Not this, Zora.
Your head's a stingray, dude. Ever in Mipha's heart. Oh! He's gonna remember her! He's gonna remember her! Did you ever notice that the jewelry is actually not part of the statue?
No.
I think that's her actual jewelry, and that they just put it on the statue when it was finished. Because it's not the same color as the rest of it, you know?
No.
At least I think that's what happened. The statue looks like it's bigger than her, though, so maybe they resized it.
I was thinking. This reminds me of the time we first met. You were just a reckless child. Always getting yourself hurt at every turn.
At least Eric is doing that.
Every time, I would heal you, just as I'm doing right now. I thought it was funny how, being a Hylian, you looked grown up so much faster than I did.
I love her. Why does she have to be dead?
I was always willing to heal your wounds.
You know?
Even back then.
Sad.
Yeah.
So if this Calamity Ganon does in fact return, what can we really do? We just don't seem to know much about what we'll be up against. But know this, that no matter how difficult this battle might get, if anyone ever tries to do you harm, then I will heal you. No matter when or how bad the wound, I hope you know that I will always protect you. Once this whole thing is over, maybe things can go back to how
they used to be. Oh, I miss this girl.
You know, perhaps we could spend some time together.
I don't want her to be dead. Yeah. A funny thing about the champion flashbacks that Link has there.
Yeah.
These are like his own flashbacks where it's just him and the champions that you know. And each one of them actually portrays their unique ability in some way.
Interesting.
Mipha uses her ability to heal a wound he had sustained. Daruk uses his power, his shield to protect them from falling rocks. Arbosa uses her lightning to wake up Zelda.
Okay.
When she was napping. And Rivali uses his gale to kind of show off.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Now's the time to show it! Da-da-da-da-da-da. Alright then, here's your fucking proof. Bam! It fits! Like a glove! Oh my fuck, it fits! I wonder, how did Mipha get Link's measurements, though? That is a good question.
I don't know.
Yeah, because this is way too small to fit a male Zora. Sorry, the words "you bitch" just screamed out in my head just now. That was also from Game Grumps.
Yeah.
I never imagine she would have feelings for one such as he.
You bitch!
That's what they said in the video. We're just laughing really hard at it, you know? So the top of that freaking place over there is the fucking Lynel.
Oh, nice.
Oh, God, he's so shocked. Okay. Need at least 20 shock arrows. Not really, I've done it with 2. Okay. I'm on it. We're gonna fucking die, aren't we? Probably.
I don't know.
Well, let's go talk to the little goddess statue first and foremost.
Okay.
We were playing this on Master Mode. There was like a fuck ton of like Lizalfos.
Yeah.
Like around the waterfalls leading up there. Mm-hmm. Art container. One more heart container so we got enough health, hopefully, for the Lynel fight. I'm a little anxious because I haven't fought this guy in a while. He's not as equipped as I am now. Let's go ahead and get her thing really quick. She's got a side quest that requires us to go to Plymouth Mountain, so...
where we're heading now.
Yeah. If someone's asking people to jump off Plymouth Mountain, you know, Grove asks us to jump off the domain at some point for a diving display, so I wouldn't be surprised if it was him asking people to jump off the fucking mountain. Gaddison. Hi, Gaddison. Ooh. Huh. Mm-hmm. Probably she's not more shocked that I'm not dead. Mm-hmm. Blah, blah. Okay. Bye. Yeah, so, the coolest thing about the Zora armor here is its ability to let us swim up waterfalls.
Yes.
I don't know how this works. It practically defies physics.
But it works.
It works, and who the fuck cares how it works, right? Woo! It's like a reverse roller coaster. Yeah, like I was saying, though, there was, like, in Master Mode, there's, like, a fuck ton of Lizalfos around here, and a lot of them actually carry, like, regular arrows, but some also carry, like, shock arrows.
True.
I wonder, do we have time to go to Toto Lake?
We'll see, why not?
Yeah, let's make a quick stop over there.
What do you gotta get there?
Fireless Frog. Over there is the Zora Helm. Bring Laflat the picture of the Lynel before you meet her. She'll give you the Zora greaves, which will make it a hell of a lot easier to swim in the boss fight.
Right. Which would be nice.
Yeah. I figure we got some time, so.
Let's do it.
downward here. Whee! Here it is, totally. Get out of the way, duck! Here somewhere. Ha! Gimme. Zora helm! Okay, I'm just gonna warp back to Zora's domain and just climb up the waterfalls again.
Okay.
Figure it'll take less time than running up the hills.
Right.
Pools of malice. Oh god, I hate those pools of malice.
Yeah, I know.
They burn like a bitch.
I'm sure.
It's kind of soft, but you do hear it, especially in the daytime. Mm-hmm. Yeah! That's what you sound like saying. Seriously, he sounds like some kind of weird banshee when he does that. Hi, Gaddison. Bet you're wondering how the fuck I just came from behind you when I went past you earlier. No? Okay. Alright. Now we just gotta go get to that damn Lynel. Shocked us with arrows. Remember, you also need like Hardy Bass to upgrade this thing to its fullest power.
Uh-huh.
I actually know a place where you can get a lot of Hardy Bass. There's like this little lake that's near where this guy wants to do like a foot race. And there's like usually like seven Hardy Bass in there.
Yeah.
And another tireless frog. And another tireless frog. Nice. I'm swimming in tireless frogs. Like, I need the tireless frogs to make, like, enduring potions. Okay, shock arrow. Two. Yes. Some here. Got one here. Like, run away, you fool! Yeah, I can't not look at the warthog and not think of, like, Pumbaa.
Right? Kuna Matata.
Yep. It means no worries for the rest of your days. Actually, let's wear this. This has higher defense, slightly. I'm just gonna save here really quick. Mm. Dragonfly. Ah, there he is. See me. Okay. Not a bad photo, actually.
No.
Oh, shit. They got fairies. No, not bad. flurry rush time.
They're like bulls.
Pretty much. Probably as close as we're going to get to an actual centaur in this game.
How many are there?
I'm not really sure. I think at least 30.
Wow.
Maybe. He has got like 8,000 hit points on him.
Wow. I don't think when I did my playthrough, I fought one of these guys.
I don't blame you. These guys are very intimidating starting off.
You said no.
Yep. All aboard the nope train, right?
I'm not going there. What are their weaknesses?
There's really nothing you can do as far as weaknesses are concerned. You just have to dodge and fight.
Yeah, just gotta ride it out.
Pretty much, yeah. Just hope you can dodge his attacks and land a few good hits on him. It's a Lynels that fight with the Lynel sword are a little easier than like ones with like a Lynel crusher. And as soon as I say that, of course, I fucking suffer hit, take a heavy hit. Blood Moon's coming up as I'm fighting this fuck.
Oh, man. So what happens?
I may have to refight this asshole.
I'll finish it before it shows up.
No, the Blood Moon comes up at 10. I don't know if I have enough time to gather all the fucking shock arrows before he either kills me or he revives. Fuck. That is just shit timing right there, man.
So you're just getting out of touch?
Yeah. I ain't chancing it.
It sucks.
Fuck!
He was right there. Almost had him, too.
I'm not chancing it. That blood moon is a shit stain.
Yeah, what happens if you fight it during a blood moon? Like, right when the blood moon appears?
It won't revive right when the blood moon appears, but at the rate it's going, he's gonna die before the blood moon, and I'm gonna be fucking stuck having to fight his ass all over again as I'm getting shock arrows. God, that's intense. Look at that shit. I should have waited... until the fucking blood moon has passed before I fucking fought it.
That's why we play the game.
Ay, fuck. Yeah, I can see. Look how quickly that thing's rising. Only an hour to go. Even if I killed it beforehand, there's no way I could have gotten the shock arrows before it fucking decided, hey, time to be reborn. Let's fight again.
Right.
Hopefully when I go back, it'll still be at that weakened health, you know? Fuck. My reaction to the fucking blood moon as it's rising up over the horizon. God. This music is so fucking creepy when it plays.
It is.
I figure I'd rather just beat a hasty retreat. Yeah, I see his health meter is down still. Let's hope it fucking stays that way. I just have to look up the blood moon as it's happening, though. can't not do it. It's right there. Yeah, like I said, the first blood moon occurred while I was, like, doing some off-screen ruby grinding, so won't get the full cutscene this time.
Jeez.
It's very freaky the first time it happens, though. Thank God I'm not playing this on Master. Okay, good. His health is still very down. Alright, you fucker. Time to die. Okay. This is it! Ugh. Fucking blood moon. Bleh. Fucking blood moon, man.
Jeez.
Doesn't matter. He's dead. I got his shit. I even got his guts. Drop this Lizzle bow. What shield can I drop? And reinforced Lizzle shields are a dime a dozen. I'll take that. Alright, let's get these fucking shock arrows. Hey, God. That was nerve-wracking when that just fucking came out of nowhere.
Right.
Enemies use shock arrows, they can get stuck in the ground, but when I use them, they don't.
I don't know.
Oh, well.
Probably different arrows, I guess.
No, they're the same. I accidentally hit the wrong button there. Shock arrows everywhere. I know I already had some, but it's like I wanted to have extra. Because it's free shock arrows, so, you know, why not? I mean, you can actually, just follow his patrol line.
Yeah.
You can actually just follow his patrol line, but it's tricky doing it that way.
Because
you still have to be all sneaky, sneaky.
Right.
Chuck. On the tree, Link. God, you're worse than Epona during the race thing. As soon as I saw the aura coming off the moon, I'm like, fuck! Well, that's been dealt with, at least. Yeah, see, it's already 2:45 on the timer there.
Yeah.
Even after I killed the Lynel would have just reappeared right here as I was collecting shock arrows.
Jeez.
Mm-hmm.
So you were really having no time, if you think about it.
Nope. So, thanks, game, for making me look like an ass. Alright, so we have a whopping 43. Whoa, look at that shit.
Wow. Well, imagine you just try to jump right off.
Hmm.
Whee!
I've actually dove. Oh, wow, look at that. There's SIDON over there. I'm gonna get a photo off of this really quick. This is actually too good of an image to pass up.
Nice.
Whoa. and put your head up. That's fucking awesome. Alright, before I go talk to him, I'm gonna talk to Laflat and get the Zora greaves.
Mm-hmm.
Just so I'll have the full set ready. And, oh, what's this? Oh, a night shield. Oh, but I can't take it. My armory is full.
Oh, boy.
Oh well. Well, thankfully, Zora's domain is right over here. Have a look in time wise. 31?
Yeah, 31 minutes in.
Okay. Thank God I got that extra health. I'm pretty sure one hit from that Lynel would have killed me had it not been for that.
Yeah, it could have.
Yeah.
Hi.
Here's your fucking Lynel photo. I almost died to get it, but there it is. It's actually a nice shot with the sunset in the background, though.
It is.
I might keep that. He's like, hey, you kid, get the hell off my lawn!
Get off my lawn. Get off my lawn.
I remember I once got a super intimidating one of him, like, right in front of me about to strike.
Go all Clint Eastwood.
Yeah. Alright, got Zora Greaves. Now we'll have way better swimming when fighting the boss. I might get the armor upgraded off screen though. Alright. Okay, back to Sidon. There we go. There, now it looks like a true warrior of the Zoras. Ooh, look at me. Looking good in blue.
Yeah.
Alright. Alright. About to go see a super cinematic, I don't know if you can really call it a boss fight. It's really more just getting entry to the thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know.
That's a keeper. That's a keeper. This I might delete. In fact, I'm deleting it now. I like getting photos of like the divine beast just acting like shit stains.
Right.
Just because, I don't know why, it's very ominous and it's like memory making, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, so many stairs! That reminded of Yu-Gi-Oh! The Abridged series when Seth Kaiba was screaming. Oh my god, so many stairs! Alright. Here we are, about to face the beast. Let's just take a moment to appreciate this, because this is fucking well done for the Switch's engine, you know?
That is so cool.
Yeah. Like, GameCube couldn't pull this off.
No, hell no.
Hmm. Although
three systems.
Although GameCube did really improve on graphics, so that set up the groundwork for these newer graphics, you know?
Oh yeah. There was three systems back.
Yeah.
Before the Wii even was around.
Yeah.
Or let alone the Wii U and the Switch.
Yeah, this is actually four systems ahead.
Crazy.
Mm-hmm.
They keep making them, don't they?
He's so tiny compared to that thing. Yeah, those glowing pink orbs up there. I'm red. Now, I've seen people deflect, like, this thing's blocks of ice using arrows, and I always cringe, because I'm like, Dude, it's got the same symbols as the ones from the room. Why not just use the Cryonis room to destroy them? That's how I've always done it. It just made sense to me. Frenic bow set.
Did we get rid of that ice?
No.
See, it's got the same rune as the ice blocks when you use Cryonis.
Same.
Now.
I think actually I did it with a sword. We played a baseball. I swing at it with my claymore.
Sequences, but if you're smart about it, you can do it in two. I had to do it in three because I missed my first shot. Very cinematic, and I love it.
Best part of the game.
I know, right? So I mean, like, with the way Sidon's moving and the ice blocks and everything, they went all out for this one.
They really did.
I mean, the Vah Ruta was also pretty cinematic.
Right.
I would say Vah Ruta was too, but not in the same regard, because you're just like kind of flying around. This one, there feels like there's a sense of danger. I mean, there's a sense of danger in all of them, but, you know. I would say Rudania is the least intimidating, because you're not really, you're not really doing anything besides, like, sneaking around.
No.
It's not as intense, I guess, is the word I would use.
True.
Well, Link, here we are. Looks like this is where the real work starts. Best of luck. Nice job cutting off the water flow from this divine beast.
All right. I wish he could come in with me. I wish he could so we could say goodbye to his sister.
I'll see you back at Zora's domain. Farewell.
Divine Beast. About 10 episodes in, but we're finally here.
Yep.
Yeah, 40 minutes in. Okay.
You want to tackle it, or?
I kind of want to do that separate.
Okay. Yeah, I agree.
So, I mean, it's a little time consuming. It's not very long, but it is going to be at least half an hour, I think.
Okay.
You, Mipha?
To see that this day has finally arrived. Now, Ruta can be freed of Ganon's control.
Oh, Mipha.
You'll need a map to prevent you from getting lost.
Why must the cinnamon roll be dead?
Well, memories.
The guidance stone there contains the information that you will need.
All right, Mipha. Well, we have to cut it off here for now. I hate you, Malice.
But that was I.
All right, well, we're going to have to cut it off here for now. So next time, we will take down this gargantuan divine beast. It looks smaller in Age of Calamity for some reason.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, it's a lot more detailed.
I don't know. But either way, we'll see you all next time. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and we shall see you then. Have a good one.
Take care.
Fuck off, Malice Eyeball.